Let's talk about the silicon solar cell and how we turn sunlight into electricity, and then show you a little activity to play with kids. Here's our solar photovoltaic array, which is the entire system. Each array is made up of a number of modules. Each module has individual cells. Somewhere between 60 and 72 cells is common. If I were to cut that cell in half and look inside that cell at the silicon crystal, I would have a bunch of silicon atoms, each with four valence electrons. Those valence electrons like to move around in the crystal and can be excited by photons from the sun. But to get them to move in the direction I want, I need an electric field. And so I'm going to use some other atoms that have different numbers of electrons in the valence band, phosphorus and boron. Phosphorus with five valence electrons is going to go on the upper surface of that crystal. Boron with three valence electrons is going to go on the lower surface. When I have added those impurities, I've created an area with some extra electrons in the phosphorus and an area with some extra holes or gaps in that valence band. And so generally I have some negative area on the top and a positive on the bottom. And in this case, the phosphorus creates N-type silicon and the boron creates P-type. The N stands for negative, the P stands for positive. Those extra electrons are going to migrate down towards the extra holes. And there I've got now my PN junction and my permanent electric field. If I add some metallic contacts that now can catch those excited electrons, I have a silicon solar cell. A photon can come in from the sun, exciting an electron, causing it to flow, finding the metallic contact. If I've got a load, it gives up its energy to the load, in this case lighting the light bulb, and then keeps on flowing past and filling the hole that was left. So if I watch that in continuous motion, I can see that as my photon comes in, exciting my electron into the conduction band, attaching, finally making contact with the metallic contact, and I go in a circle. Now, if I look at that in another way, where I add the holes movement, every time that electron is excited into the conduction band and moves, I have what the gap that was left or the hole. So let's watch that again. And the hole is moving in the opposite direction as the electron. So my electron comes and fills the hole, but the hole is moving in the opposite direction. And that's important because the direction of the movement of holes is the electric current, and the direction of movement of the electrons is in the opposite direction of the electric current. So if I was going to label those from an electric current standpoint, I would label them positive going counterclockwise and negative going clockwise. And the reason that that is because that was the observations of Ben Franklin, and he observed that electricity was flowing from positive to negative, but in reality is the holes are flowing in that direction. To play the game, we're going to line as many kids up as we have. I've done this with fairly small numbers, six or seven kids, and very large numbers, 30 or 40. We line them up in rows, and I like to have them reach forward and touch the shoulder of the person in front of them to get the spacing on the rows. And the kids are the electrons in the silicon solar cell. I'm going to then designate a direction or a PN junction and say that this is the direction they're going to flow. And it depending on where I'm standing, I could be in this case up, and it could be forward. If we're doing this on a basketball court, we might have a line and show here's a PN junction and the positive side is one side of that. I want to designate a load for them to give up their energy to. That could be a person to high five or something for them to spin or touch. I want to have a path that they're going to follow, and in this case, like the metallic contact. If I'm outside, I might just show them what that path is, but if I'm inside on a basketball court, you might have some lines. The sun, which in this case a lot of times is one of the teachers, is going to throw the photon. I use ping pong balls. I've used wadded up recycle paper that then I can recycle again. I've also just walked through the group and tapped them on the shoulder to designate that electron is excited and now is going to flow in the direction of the positive electric field and then contact the metallic contact and flow. And so once you've designated that path, here's one of the kids flowing, giving up his energy to the load, the other kids filling those holes, and then finally the electron returning back to the back. And so you can imagine the electrons flowing in the clockwise direction and the holes flowing in the counterclockwise direction. This is also a fun activity to teach about power and energy. And here is kind of my designation of the game and some options and some of the details, and also what we're trying to get these kids to learn about photons and about the sun's rays, and that I kind of describe these photons as little packets of energy. They're both little packets of energy and wavelengths of light at the same time. Different wavelengths have different amounts of energies. Shorter wavelengths have more energy. We can also talk about how that solar cell turns that energy into electricity, which we just demonstrated. And then finally, we can talk about the nature of electricity and power and energy. In the case of power and energy, power is a rate, and energy is the total amount. So if I'm starting to throw those photons very slowly, and I could go very slow for a long amount of time, or I could go very fast for a short amount of time. If I go very fast, I have high power. And if I go very slow, I have low power. But if I go slow for long enough, I can have the same amount of energy as if I went fast for a short amount of time. So I can talk about power and energy. And if I'm imagine playing that game and I'm throwing the balls very fast, it gets pretty crazy pretty quick. And that's fine. I might play, let it get a little crazy, and then I reset and we'll start again. And it works very good, and the kids have a lot of fun doing this activity, and I encourage you to give it a try. You can find more of my videos at my YouTube page, CropWatch Bioenergy.